Hi, I'm Chris Summers with Unhedged.
And I'm Austin Hankwitz. And today we're going to have a conversation about a really interesting idea that is taking place in the agriculture markets, specifically with a company called CF Industries. Chris, walk me and the audience through what is so interesting right now with CF Industries.
Sure. If you've ever driven through the Midwest, chances are you saw some cornfields. In the United States, our largest two crops are corn and soybeans. In fact, we plant over 170 million acres of corn and soybeans each year. This year's corn and soybean crop will be worth over $150 billion, up from $80 to $90 billion last year. Farming all these corn and soybeans requires land, equipment, seeds, and fertilizer. When the price of corn and soybeans goes up, the prices of the land, seed, and fertilizer tend to rise as well. Demand for crops this year is so strong that we now have a shortage of supply, driving the price of corn and soybeans to their highest level in years. And in the past few months, the price of the fertilizers for growing corn and soybeans have also risen dramatically.
So Chris, you're saying the price of these fertilizers have grown dramatically because the price of corn is up and people want to purchase this fertilizer to make sure that they can, you know, grow more corn, which is in turn making them more money. What's the timeline on these high prices for fertilizers, for corn, for all this stuff?
As of right now, the corn and soybean prices have done most of their increase starting from the beginning of this year. Typically, the fertilizer pricing lags by a few months, so we didn't really see the major fertilizer prices start to increase until the second quarter. As a result, a lot of the publicly traded fertilizer companies have not yet reported a quarter reflecting these higher fertilizer prices. And generally, these cycles tend to last 3 or 4 years. The most recent one was in 2010, and that one lasted until 2014. And during that entire period, the prices of fertilizers remained elevated.
Perfect. And I think it would be interesting if you have the chart on hand. I know there's a really cool chart through Unhedged website that allows you to compare the price of corn to the price of these fertilizers. And last time I saw the chart, the price of fertilizers and the price of corn moved together very, very closely. But right now, it seems like the price of corn has skyrocketed with the price of fertilizer really lagging behind. As you mentioned, none of this, I guess, has happened in such a way that has allowed these companies to report on this increased price in fertilizer. Do you have that chart by chance?
Yes, I do. If you look at my screen here, you can see starting back in 2010, the orange line is the price of corn, and then you can see the price of fertilizer rising in lockstep with it. And then after the cycle ended in 2014, you can see the price of corn fell again, and so did the price of fertilizer. Now, when you turn your attention to the first half of 2021, you can see the price of corn has gone up dramatically, and the price of fertilizers, as reported by the fertilizer companies, has not yet followed suit. But the most recent data in the market intelligence suggests that now fertilizer prices have indeed correlated back up to the price of corn and are at much higher levels, which should be reflected in the second and third quarter results this year.
Perfect. So with that being said, right, the fertilizer prices are moving up higher now to really come closer with the increased price in corn. What does that mean for CF Industries as the company themselves? Give me some numbers, Chris. Let's talk about it.
Sure. So during depressed times, which the last few years were during the agricultural trough we just went through, the average price of fertilizer that CF Industries realized was only around $200 per ton. And on that basis, they were only making gross profits of around $40 to $50 per ton. Okay. Now that the aggregate price is closer to $400, which is in line with where the fertilizer prices were during 2010 through 2014, almost that entire increase flows to the bottom line. So while the price of the fertilizer is doubled from $200 to $400, the gross profits actually also increase by that $200 increment. So the gross profits should rise from around $50 to $250, or a five-fold increase on the backs of a doubling in fertilizer prices.
So what I'm hearing is it costs this company about $150 to make a ton of fertilizer, which they would then sell for $200 or a $50 per ton profit. But now since the cost of making this fertilizer is still $150, but the price people are willing to pay for the fertilizer has increased up to, you know, this, you know, a potentially $200, $300, $400, you know, price per ton. This gross profit has now increased from $50 per ton of fertilizer to $250 per ton of fertilizer, a 5X. Did I understand that correctly?
Yep, that's exactly right. And that's what happened the last cycle. And that's what tends to happen with these fertilizer companies during every cycle. And with the current price of fertilizers, CF Industries may well be able to generate over $10 per share of earnings over the next 12 months. And for perspective, Wall Street analysts are currently only projecting about $3 per share of earnings. A lot of this disconnect is for a couple of reasons. One, these stocks are not closely followed currently by Wall Street analysts, as the entire industry has been in a bit of a lull for the last few years. And secondly, the publicly traded fertilizer companies have not yet reported results for the second quarter that will start to reflect some of these elevated fertilizer prices.
Got it. So whenever they do report these results, do you think they'll specifically call out this reason as a catalyst for these higher, and assuming they report higher than expected revenue and earnings, do you think they'll call out this specific fertilizer increase in, you know, gross profit as a catalyst for that?
Yes, I think, and the analysts will be very focused on it as well. The major questions are going to be, you know, how long is this going to last? Why do we have such strong demand this year for corn? Is it China? And the answer to that is yes, a lot of it's been China. It's also been a recovery in demand for all food things with restaurants reopening. A lot of corn goes into growing proteins, chicken, cattle, etc. During a June conference call, the CFO of CF Industries indicated that he felt we were at the beginning of a multi-year positive upcycle in the agriculture space, which would lead people to believe that the earnings power that CF Industries can achieve with these current fertilizer prices may be sustained for multiple years now.
Love it. Love it. So just to hit everyone with a big high-level summary and make sure, you know, call me out if I'm wrong here, Chris, but it seems like the price of corn is increasing and it's entering the sort of multi-year cycle, bull market cycle, this agriculture bull market. And with that increased price in corn comes an increased price in fertilizer, because assuming more people want to buy fertilizer, the price goes up. And so CF Industries is a major player in the fertilizer selling type space. And so if they're making fertilizer for $150 and instead selling it from $200 a ton now to $400 a ton, their gross profits are going to increase exponentially, driving their earnings per share higher.
Yep, that's exactly right. And the last two cycles that this occurred, the stock prices of the fertilizer companies tend to perform extremely well. And as an added kicker and benefit for CF Industries this time around compared to the last cycle, which I think a lot of investors might miss, is during the last 8 or 9 years, the company has had fairly good and disciplined capital allocation. And what that means is, what have they been doing with the money they earned? And in the case of CF Industries, they've nearly doubled their manufacturing capacity. So when you think about the profits they earned during the last cycle, the profits can almost be two times higher because they're making twice as much product this time than they were 8 years ago. And secondly, during the last 8 years, they also have reduced their share count by over 30%. So in 2012 or 13, they had over 300 million shares outstanding. And today they only have 210 million shares outstanding. So to put that into perspective, let's say the stock price were $100 per share. 10 years ago, that would mean the company's valued at over $30 billion. Today, because they bought back so much stock, the company's only valued at $20 billion. So it makes the stock worth 50% more on an apples to apples basis from having that share count reduction, which is, in Wall Street terms, they call that the accretiveness of the share repurchase program.
Love that. Love that. Yeah, this has been incredible. You know, I think that people are going to definitely give us some feedback on this. And if you guys listening right now are following this closely or know anything more about CF Industries, and definitely, you know, share it with us. And we're definitely interested to learn more about your guys' perspectives.
Awesome. Thanks a lot for joining, Austin. This was a lot of fun. And hopefully people found this to be a fairly interesting situation.
Most definitely. See you, Chris.
Great. Thanks, guys.